5 minutes. And we will now, it's moved and seconded. Pretty sure we've probably had the debate and the questions, but we'll take it from the top and we'll scroll up to A, just so that you know what you're voting on. I think we've managed to incorporate everything and there's general agreement on everything. A, B, we'll go down to C and D. And remember, the first change was in E. There it is for you, stating that it's going to be endorsed at the GB meeting coming up. And then we'll go down to H, I think, is the next change. Happy with that? Then we scroll down further. And the next one is at K. Yep. Covers that off. And then we go to the ones that have been raised mostly today. So M, if you can read that. And that reflects Councillors Fletcher and Quacks. All good, members? And we go to N, point I raised about the yield on brownfields, taking into account those exemplar proposals. All good. And then we go to the O, which is reflects Councillor Brewer's matter. Councillor Brewer, all good?
Good.
And we're done. Is there any debate on Councillor Webster?
Sorry, Mr. Chairman, there is just one other issue that I want to bring up, and it's something that particularly my colleagues, Councillor Walker and Councillor Watson, would be involved. You know, when something goes wrong with a development, can you assure me, Bree, that we the development that comes in that gets proposed, i.e., you know, good design, urban design, town centre, amenities, actually then gets appended somewhere so they can't change that? I mean, you know what happened in Gulf Harbour when we had, you know, the original development was going to be absolutely stunning, fantastic, and then they sell off a bit of here and sell off a bit there. And then you end up with a complete...
full of leaky homes.
I was going to say something even worse, but never mind. So can we, you know, have we got certainty of that? Because, I mean, some of these bigger SHAs are going to take quite a few years, and we want to make sure that, like areas like Kensington Park and Millwater, you actually get what you started out with.
Yeah, through
Boston Road.
Yeah. Through Mr. Chair, when you're assessing the establishment of SHA, we're not actually assessing the detailed development. But what we do receive from the applicants or requesters is sometimes some plans of how they might develop. But the discretion still remains with the housing staff when they receive either a plan variation or a qualifying development consent to ensure that the detailed planning requirements are met. Those detailed planning requirements on urban design, etc., are higher under the unitary plan generally than they are under the operative plans. And we will put conditions on consent to make sure that those are maintained. If they're not maintained, then it gets into an issue of compliance and enforcement. And that is really the mechanism. All of these developments, particularly in the greenfield areas, will be stage developments where they're large, you know, and often there is a consent for a super lot, and then there's a subsequent consent for the subdivision and the dwelling development. But we are only doing those through the guidelines, and we do promote very good design. What we are about to do is our consenting team in the housing office has shown quite a lot of developments that we've influenced with the applicants on a collaborative basis, and I have suggested that we bring those to this committee to demonstrate so that you can have that confidence.
Thank you. And through you, Mr. Chairman, I mean, on page 44, it does say the following indicators may assist. Indication from the developer they work with, urban design advice, etc., size and location, amenities, track record, all that sort of thing. I mean, if they're coming in for an SHA, obviously they're going to promise the earth. I just want to make sure that we actually follow that through, that the earth gets delivered.
We absolutely do, and we do look at track record.
Great, thanks.
Thanks, Councillor. So if we just go to the M, I've just changed it there. I've brackets on strategic location and capitals, comma. And then there was It may take account, but I don't think that's what I heard from the councillors. I thought they wanted it to take account. So I've just changed the word to will there, but I'll go to councillors Fletcher and Quacks very briefly after he wipes up the tea.
My colleague and I have been conferring over coffee, and we wonder whether it would be better proximity to existing and emerging employment areas. So we don't actually think the major, you know, there may be too much weighting on the word major, but it does need to recognise existing and emerging employment areas. So if you could make that alteration. While I have the floor and waiting for my colleague who may wish to further add to this, could I just query under O, given a preference for higher yielding brownfield sites, that early extensive consultation with local boards and local councillors remains a priority. I think that's great. But what happens and how do officers interpret this? If you take a local board like Albert Eden that don't want any SHAs at all, how would officers actually... Could you give an interpretation on how officers respond to that type of situation?
Well, through Mr. Chair, irrespective of whether a local board is supportive or otherwise of a special housing area, the idea is that we engage with them as early as possible and as fully as possible so that we can receive those views. And it has, that recommendation is indicating, noting a called time frame. So we have to do it in a what is called a reasonable and timely fashion to the best of our ability, taking all of those circumstances into account.
I think Councillor Quacks is just... You ready?
Yeah. He's going to wipe the floor.
Now that I've done my homework in my house...
Councillor Quacks.
I've done my housework.
He's multitasking.
I think... But you've got it right now. It's right
you're
now.
Happy?
Yeah,
right.
I think I'm happy with that, yeah. I think... That's exactly what I envisaged. Thank you.
And then just going through we're good with M, we're good with N, and O, the word extensive, are we comfortable with that, members? I mean, that could send a signal to local boards that no matter what the Housing Project Office does, it's never enough.
Maybe early consultation. Maybe it's redundant, really.
Yeah. Take out extensive and just...
Take out extensive.
Early?
Yeah.
Nothing else to add? Councillor Walker.
I just have a question, and it follows on from the question or the issue that Councillor Webster raised, and it goes to achieving deliverables, making sure that these special housing developments are of the quality that the applicants apply for, that infrastructure and other issues are dealt with. And the reason that I'm asking this question is what I see happening, and I think a number of people see happening out there, is that these special housing areas are a mechanism for speculators and developers to rack up the value of properties. Often it is the case where the special housing area may be sought ahead of a sale or the like to enhance the value. Increasingly, they're being on-sold to other developers after a considerable amount of value has been extracted. Much of this process relies on, I would suggest, the present bubble housing market and the demand, so-called, that exists presently. And I would suggest that there is a very large risk that things fall apart, that you don't have the quality of development, particularly in special housing areas, and there are some of them in the Albany ward that I regard as very marginal and not marketable,
in
areas
to what
that it's not even desirable for people to live.
Councillor Walker, what is
so
the question?
So my question...
No, wait on.
My question is...
No, I'm asking you, because I... What is your question on the criteria?
My question is it possible to have some criteria that goes to the matter that I'm raising? In some instances, for example, around consenting processes, there are bonds and the like that are imposed so that you actually have some certainty if something falls over. because we're going to have a number of these special housing areas all over. Some of them will be partly built.
That's why I said before we took the break, I would hope that we'd come back and we would thrash out all the contributions and then put the motion. But David or Ree?
Dear Mr. Chair, we have the certainty of the unitary plan rules which we apply. They are outcome focused, so they actually give us more flexibility to get better developments. The other is we have conditions on consents about timeliness of delivery. So in other words, if you don't use it, you lose it. And we would probably have an average of 2 years on any consent as opposed to 5 years that you get under the resource management legislation. In addition to that, we are now entering into memorandum of understandings, infrastructure funding agreements to ensure that the delivery of the infrastructure that is promised is delivered. And we will enhance that even further with some of the new special housing areas coming through where a developer indicates that they might supply infrastructure, say, of a community nature, that there is agreement before the SHA is approved. So we really welcome those opportunities. And I think through the special housing area process, in fact, we have enhanced that already.
Through you, Mr. Chair.
Councillor Walker, and
specifically, I've got a question about, let's say, a bond. The history that we've had around leaky buildings is you have shell companies, and we have such companies involved with special housing areas.
Councillor Walker, I'm going to call
it quits. They just go belly up.
No,
Councillor
Walker, everybody had the opportunity to refine the criteria before we took the break, and now you're coming in very late, and there's a lot of comment beyond the criteria here. And it's interesting, but it's not what we're here for here today. It's not the subject matter here today. So I'm going to put the motion now. It's moved and seconded. All those in favour say aye. Contrary, no, and declare that carried. Thanks to the Housing Project Office team that are here today.
Probably when something goes
back. We'll now go to the next item. There's no extraordinary. Therefore, we're going to public.
It is just
so I need to move the procedural. It's moved by Councillor Clough.
Thank you.
I'll second it then. All those in favour say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. Declare that carried. So this part of the meeting, thank you to members of the public that are here.
Thank you for being here, members of the public.